Hello everyone, this is the grandly titled Racetrack Ralphy's preview to the 2011 Cox Plate Day. This is the punting strategy session. You know, I don't give you my first selection, followed by my second selection, followed by my third selection, followed by my fourth selection, as if you can just pick a first four out of you know where. No, we try and give you some strategic advice when it comes to having a punt, and it's worth keeping in mind the thoughts of the great Bart Cummings when he says patience is the cheapest thing in racing and the least used. You don't have to have a bet on every race, although some people forget that. Well, race one is a two-year-old race. Now, before we have a look at the two-year-old race, keep in mind if you're having a sports bet, for instance. If you have a bet on AFL footy, you're happy to. But would you have a bet on Auskick, you know, the under sevens? Of course you wouldn't. Well, nothing worse than, you know, if little Johnny turns up with shin soreness. That's my point. Why would you bet on two-year-old racing? The horses aren't even grown. You haven't seen them race. A couple have had a barrow trial, a couple have had a race here and there. And basically, it's a guess. No thanks. Race two on the program is over a mile, and it's for the mares, and I'm a little bit more interested here. I'm going to risk the favourite, Twilighting. Now, Twilighting, one last start over this track and distance, and you're thinking, why would you risk it? Mooney Valley has two tracks. There's rail out seven, of which you want to be on leaders, rail back in the true position, as it is today and at other feature meetings, which time you want to be on swoopers. I know that's a general rule, but general rules are what wins you on the punt in the long run. Twilighting got a very soft lead last start with the rail out seven. Today it's favourite. It's like people forget that there's two different Mooney Valleys. I'm not forgetting it, and I am going to risk it. Granted, there's not much pace in the race, and I'll probably get a soft lead again, but there's two that really interest me. The horse that ran second to it, Classic L. Now, it did get back. It carried 59 kilos, so it drops a heap in weight. Drawn okay, won't have to get as far back, and because the rail's in the true position, will get its chance. The other one that really interests me is Urali. Barrier one, go to sleep barrier, it'll probably sit midfield. It's got a turn of foot, and it drops in class with virtually the same amount of weight. Now, if that isn't a recipe for success, I don't know what. And the Snowden camp this year, particularly, has been fantastic at targeting black-type races for their mares. So, Urali, around about $8, and a little bit on Classic L as well. Well, race three over 1,200 metres, and I'm risking the favourite again, and I'm risking a leader again. And my nuts, well, time will tell. But Curata Queen knows one pace, flat out. Now, flat out at Mooney Valley over 1,200 metres when you're a 1,000-metre horse, that is recipe for getting beaten. So I'm going to prepare myself for it being beaten. Two horses of interest, Armour Rock, and it's had two wins. It's probably had a setback. You can only guess because it's had a fair gap since its last run, but gee, it looked like a good horse in the making. And with the pace on here, you know it's going to really be belting the line if it's right. If it blows right out the gate, well, it's going to lessen your interest a bit because it probably means the stable aren't overly happy with Armour Rock. The other one at pretty big odds here is Glissade, 25-1. Now, last start, nothing went right for it. It had to go forward due to only a fair speed in the race. Wet track didn't suit it, and it compounded. McAvoy, Snowden, they're not the type of stable to keep pushing their horses unless they're happy with it. So with a drier surface today, guaranteed pace with Curata Queen in the race, then you definitely want to be having a look at massive odds here. And the other one that will probably be second favourite, you probably want to save on it, from Peter Moody, the Sandic Colours, is Beckon. It's definitely a winning chance, but the two that really interest me are Armour Rock, particularly if there's any money for it, and Glissade. I don't care what odds Glissade is, the Snowdens aren't a punting team, it will be over the odds. Well, as this little session is all about the punt, we're not going to be having a bet in two races. Race four, Manawanui, is probably a superstar. He'll be about $1.12. Black Caviar, she is a superstar, be about $1.05. And the Sun coming up tomorrow is probably about $1.20. If you want to have those odds, if you want to take racehorses to win at that type of odds, good luck to you. Do it, and I'll say hello to you at the soup kitchen at one stage of my life. Race 6 on the program is the Mooney Valley Cup, and it's a learning race, probably not a betting race for this reason. If Americane, the dominant winner of the 150th Melbourne Cup last year, is right, 58 kilograms, he's thrown in. He's a superstar stayer. And I don't think they've brought him back from the Northern Hemisphere to set him for the Mooney Valley Cup, though. He'll be favourite, top weight, who knows where he'll be on the run. I just can't get excited about Americane, and if he wins and you miss out on the $3.50 or whatever he starts, big deal. You know, do you get angry when you miss a $3.50 shot? I don't think so. The other one, Ilio, Bart Cummings trains it. Now, German form. I can't even keep up with episodes of Hogan's Heroes, and I'm meant to know how good the German form is. I don't think so. If it wins, everyone will go, Bart's a genius. If it loses, everyone will go, well, you can't trust the German form. So you're guessing either way. What's the point? If you want to have a bet, there's a couple of odds that sort of interest me a little bit. Now, Linton. If Linton's right, you know he's going to run a place. Doesn't matter how good the other two are, because Linton is a very, very good horse. He put in a stinker last start in the Turnbull. Trust the stable that they've got him right, whatever the problem was. And at Moonee Valley, he's super. He had no luck last start, but he was a dominant winner of the Alistair Clark Stakes. You know, Moonee Valley Cup, he ran super in. So, you know, why not be on Linton? The other one worth a look at, and this is at pretty good odds, is Booming. Peaked on his run last start at Caulfield. He's a big lump of a horse. He's probably not that well weighted, but he's a dual Group 1 winner in New Zealand. He'll keep coming. 58 kilograms won't worry him. He could probably carry 960 kilograms. That's how big the horse is. And at good odds, if you just want to have a play bet, but I'd rather just sit back a bit here. Race 7's a really interesting race, the Crystal Mile. You got the young, emerging type of horses. You got Test of My Patience, Blackie and Happy Trails versus the old warriors, if you like. Dow Dow and what have we got? Dane Lee, Ginga Doo, Triple Elegance, Lou and Yap Forever. So it's a bit of a emerging types versus the old warriors. I'm going for the emerging types here, but the one I am going for is Happy Trails. Now, last start, you might have thought, well, he just got there, but let's try and think through the form a little bit. Carried 58 kilograms. The pace was on. It was really pulling, but he was pulling because it was Blinker's first time. The Blinker's come off. Barrier 4, he should be able to relax, but hopefully he's learnt last start not to get as far back as he used to. Position and running is just so important in horse racing. And he drops a whopping 5.5 kilograms from that run. Damien Oliver goes off. Craig Williams goes on. So you haven't lost anything. He's about 11 or 12 to 1. He's ridiculous odds. He's got another peak in him, this horse, just through his learning ability. He contested black type races as a three-year-old. I just think he's amazing over the odds in this bloke in Happy Trails. The other one, obviously, Test of My Patience. He's a winner. Winners keep winning. I know he's on the way up. You could probably do all kinds of weights and measures, look at him, but he keeps winning. So however you structure your betting, have something on Test of My Patience to break even on the race if you don't back him to win on the race, if you know what I mean. Because the ones we can get the value of, certainly Happy Trails. And the other one, knock, knock, knock on wood, Doubt Out. Today could be the day. He just wasn't even put in the race last start in the Rupert Clark Stakes. He just flopped out the back. His sectionals were dynamic. Today, Moonee Valley, Mile, Rail True. He should be able to blend in the race. He hasn't won for ages. I know all that. But he is a Group 1 horse. He's sneaking down the weights. Today could be his day. And he'll be the odds that make you not slap yourself upside the head if he does get beaten. Lou and Yat Forever is probably in a similar category, but he'll be shorter in the market. So the one I'm really interested in is Happy Trails at good odds. I don't want to let Naked, though, test my patience. Don't want to let Naked Dow Dow. Don't want to let Naked, the other one that has to be a massive chance in the race, and that is Lou and Yat Forever. But Happy Trails each way for mine at pretty good odds. Well, we could wax lyrical about the Cox Plate and it's the race of the year and yada yada, but this is about the punt. So we're going to try and strategize this a little bit. Helmet is a superstar. Do you want to risk him? Well, you can at the fact that, you know, three-year-olds who lead all the way, who show dynamic speed, are a little bit vulnerable in Cox Plates, but he's a superstar. Don't let him go around naked. Back him a little bit, back others a bit more. That's the way I'm sort of approaching the race. Lion Tamer. Now, he's going to be aggressive on him, this horse. There's no question. He'll be humming across and he'll be taking Helmet on. But these two might be able to keep kicking. They are high-class horses. Lion Tamer, though, at 15 or 16 to 1 or whatever is on offer, off one poor run at Caulfield when he got back. Today, Blinker's back on. He'll go forward. He'll be part of that humming tempo. Well, he could be a very good horse, Lion Tamer, as well. So I'm definitely having both of them to make sure I cover myself on the race. But the horse is just going to get the gun run of all times, Glass Harmonium. Damien Oliver aboard. Every horse that he's run against has broken down afterwards. I'm not laughing at the fact they've broken down, but I'm saying you can't actually line up the form. You know, My Kingdom of Fife broke down. Littorio broke down. December Draw. Let's look at it this way. If December Draw had have come out and won the Caulfield Cup by 5 lengths, everyone would be raving about the form of Glass Harmonium. Now, he didn't, but he broke down. So you don't know the way he was backed, the way the Kavanagh team and was thinking about it, Michael Rodd and so forth. December Draw might be a star. Glass Harmonium ran him tight. You know he's going to get that beautiful run just behind the speed, and he'll be the first one to challenge. So Glass Harmonium for mine, for position running, each way forever. I know Rekindled Interest can run on. I know Secret Admire can run on. But give me the tough horse at 12 or 13 to 1 with a great jockey, great trainer in Mike Moroney every day of the week. So Glass Harmonium each way for mine. Massive respect for Helmet. Little bit of respect for Lion Tamer at big odds too. Last race on the program, there's a couple of tips here. One is make sure you've organised a cab to get out the joint. The last race is around about 6:30. What's all that about? The other one is with Avianis now running in the Cox Plate, tiny bit of pace comes out of the race, it'll still be genuine. The two I want to look at is Nerianni, who was amazing last start. In fact, if the biggest worry looking at Nerianni's form was, did that run gas her? She was three wide on the speed and just kept fighting. She drops in weight. Craig Williams goes on, barrier one. So if she, and I don't necessarily think she has to lead. Last start, they tried the aggressive tactics. She might just get that sweet seat run right behind the leader. And the one right behind her is Raspberries. Again, big odds here. And again, as I mentioned earlier, the Snowden team, so good at setting mares for black type races. She probably peaked through the roof two starts back at Newcastle. She beat subsequent winners and in open class, of course. You got Ginga Dude and also Neeson, who came from the race already. And that was a dominant performance. Then the Epsom was a good enough performance. If she peaks again, she's right in this race and she'll be about 10 to 1. And from barrier two, she's going to get the best run of all time. So definitely Raspberries each way to finish the day off, but hopefully you're well in front.